There are three steps you need to know about to make your drawings splendiferously colorful. Let's start by coloring the background. To do that, just type background and then an open parenthesis, and the rest of the line will complete for you. Now, if you look closer, you'll notice that this is actually a function call. See, we've got the name of the function here, which is background, and then those two parentheses and three parameters inside separated by commas. Now, these three numbers represent the amount of red, the amount of green, and the amount of blue in the background color. And the numbers can go anywhere between 0 and 255, where 0 means there's none of that color, and 255 means we're maxing out on that color. So right now, we're maxing out on red, and there's no green or blue, which is why the background is a super bright red. If I made the first number smaller, then there would be less red, so it's just a darker red. And I can keep playing around with these numbers and see what kind of colors I can come up with. Or I can use our handy-dandy color picker, which will set all three numbers for me. Now, it's important to know that what this background function is really doing is just drawing a big colored square over the entire canvas. So if I moved it to the end of my program like this, then it would draw that big background square over all my shapes. And maybe you're thinking, well, that's stupid. Why would anyone want that? But hey, you never know. Still, we're going to leave it at the top for now. So now to color our shapes. It might be helpful to think of the computer as having a color assistant or, I don't know, some sort of color butler. Basically, some dude who's in charge of his colors. And this color dude can only hold one colored marker in his left hand and one bucket of paint in his right hand. And the computer uses the colored marker to draw all of these outlines and the bucket of paint to fill in the shapes. So right now the marker is black and the bucket has white paint. You can change the color of the marker by calling this function, stroke, which also auto-completes, and then picking a color. And this switches out the marker that the color dude is holding so that all shapes drawn after this line will be drawn with a pink marker. But sometimes, maybe you don't want outlines on your shapes. Well, there's a function for that too, and it's called no stroke. And for the first time, we see a function that doesn't take any parameters. So we've just got this empty set of parentheses and then a semicolon. And now you can see that our shapes have no outlines. You can also switch out the color dude's paint bucket by calling this function, fill. And now, from this line of code forward, you will fill in all the shapes with this bright red color. And just like we had a no stroke function, we also have a, you guessed it, no fill function, which also takes no parameters. And this makes all of our shapes transparent. They're not filled in. So now let's go ahead and actually color this dude. So we start out by drawing a triangle for his body. So I'm going to pick a stroke color for it. Set the outline. I don't know, let's do a dark green. That's pretty good. And pick a fill color. What would be nice for that? Maybe just a lighter green. Lighter green. It's nice. For his face, well, I don't want his face to have a green outline, so I'm going to change the stroke color for his face. And I could do like a dark tan brownish kind of outline, and then pick a different fill color. Yikes. Ooh, what's a good face color? That's kind of like a face color, right? Alright, now the next two lines, these two ellipses are for his hands, and I want his hands to be the same color as his face. So I'm not going to switch out that marker, I'm not going to switch out that paint bucket, we're just going to leave the stroke and fill the same. And move on to his mouth. Now his mouth is just this line here. And lines don't have fill colors because, well, there's nothing to fill in. But we can change the stroke color of this line. So yeah, red's a pretty good color for a mouth. And his glasses frames, again, we only need to set the stroke. It's a good color for glasses. Black is pretty classic. And for his glasses lenses, I want these rectangles to have the same outline as the glasses frames. So I'm not going to change the stroke color, but I will give it a fill color. And let's make it black to match the frames. And there we go. Now our dude is colored. Aw, yeah.